Do you feel like over the 6 years you regret with schoolwork? Either you put in too much effort or you put in not effort at all? Effort.
Yo, fuck no! Check my SQA certificate, bruv!
Yeah, he's
not
big. He's right. I don't put in the right amount of effort.
I put in too much.
I'm in a good middle ground because I wear one of B, but I didn't sweat so hard. But I did sweat to an extent.
Absolutely not. You look at my you look at my fucking grades. Fucking, I'm insane.
If anything, I regret not working harder.
Like one of those business Instagram channels, you know, where it's like three words for success.
I made $300,000 off sleep training in a week.
Sleep, cocaine, masturbation.
Should have put in here, please. Don't follow any of those three.
What, no masturbation? What, are you some sort of fucking Mormon?
Yes.
No,
yes.
I didn't put in any effort.
Okay, well, minus that dickhead in the corner.
I regret getting a C in physics because I've been bullied for my entire life about it by Patrick Stenhouse because I started revising 3 days before the exam and I want to kill myself.
Man, I have no regrets over my exams, but I did a lot for maths. I will tell you, I did a lot for maths and then it got progressively less and less, and this year I dicked about. I did really badly.
I don't like you. I don't like you at all.
Everyone gets really upset.
I didn't do any work.
My exams.
Because, we should brag about it.
Yeah.
Like a dickhead.
Why wouldn't I? I did nothing. I did well.
I definitely lost all of it because I played computer games.
So, who needs hires if you're good at Rust?
Yeah, who needs fucking that five geography?
I mean, I wish I could say the same for Matthew, but he sucks at every single game we play consecutively.
Wait, so who do you know is good at schoolwork and also good at gaming? Oh, wait. Me.
I don't really think there was any effort.
Come on,
<Jesus. laughs>
I revise for like a few hours a day.
Maybe an hour or two the day before and then tried cramming in the morning.
Yeah, like a few hours, 3 days before.
I mean, I don't think I had any good results.
You got higher?
Yeah, I've got higher.
Yeah,
it's
C, right,
C's.
Yeah, but C's, yeah.
I've got two or three B's.
Oh, I'm smart. I'm putting all the work. Okay. No, the thing is, I'm not even smart. I just put in heaps and, like, I'm such a sweat that it just, like, all works out.
I, like, didn't revise for my NAT 5s or my highers. And since I'm, like, decently, like, intelligent, I kind of knew, but, like, I didn't. So I got enough grades, and the fact that I went, like, I don't have any regrets now because I got into university. At the time, when my, like, NAT 5 on my higher results came in, I did cry.
I would definitely put in more effort in fifth year, but my heart was broken, so I didn't. I didn't like the stress of sixth year. Even though I did fuck all, I still got my conditions. Thank you, Mrs. Smith.
It doesn't matter how I got it.
As long as you didn't get caught.
Yeah.
But in terms of like sixth year, I just went into it and I just like every single day going into like advanced higher English and like just sitting there.
Business.
And I was just like I can't do this. I'm not gonna get any grades. And of course then the whole coronavirus happened as soon as I left pretty much. Like, of course that means I would have gotten grades. Without having to do what I was dreading to do. And yeah, well, I do regret that a little bit just because the coronavirus happened and stuff and I could have like stayed and gotten what I needed and stuff, but I do have like solid grades for higher so I can still like do stuff.
I was a bit of a nerd.
None. You're fucking
Yeah, to be
sweat.
Fair. But then at the same time, I didn't do anything in sixth year, so.
I don't think anyone did.
No. Well,
sixth year was my fifth year, and fifth year is my sixth year, because in fifth year I had 13 free theory.
Well, I think I put in a good amount of effort, the, like, not fives and highers, but
we grafted.
Yeah, I did graft quite hard, but this year I didn't do anything. But I don't regret it, because I had a fun sixth year. I fucked this year, but then the SQA changed my grades. Thanks, SQA.
Took, like, S1 to 3 less years as well, because I think, like, okay, you got your class unit tests and you're like, oh my god, shit, this like means so much, but like it didn't. And even National 5, I wish I was a bit more
it was really important at the time, but compared to hires and stuff, I would get so like stressed and be like worried about it all. And I was like, even once we'd done them, we were like, this doesn't really matter that much. It's our hires.
I feel like hires in the fall this year as well was a big one, but it didn't fucking matter.
Like, I was stressed for hires, but like, it's because it was an important kind of year.
Yeah, like you can't even deny hires being important.
She's a tryhard. Yes. That's because it's a school. But because I'm an absolute retard and I had to get like so much like extra support, I had to work hard. Mm. Oh, sorry.
Also get tested for dyslexia as soon as possible.
Yes, it helps. It really helps. We're both...
Retards.
Mine came back negative somehow.
Well, I was
my mum wants to get me tested again.
You should. Then you can join me at uni with 100% extra time, your own room and your own refrigerator, and eat cakes.
I did like history though, Thursday period 5 and 6.
Yeah, I enjoyed the part of history where I was actually learning the course, and not the part where they were like, yeah, maybe tea.
Where did it all go wrong? I think it's when I met this guy called Cammy Dining. He just got me into drinking, you know, his peer pressure, it just hit me, man.
See, that's funny, because the first time I drank was because you told me to.
I think I put in too much effort in fifth year.
I kind of just coasted.
You were like, just lucky.
I didn't put in that much effort, but I put...
You put in enough.
Like, I knew what I needed to do, basically. I knew I didn't have to go all out like Jordan, basically, and not have a life and just revise all the time, but I knew I needed to do, like, a little bit here and there. Like, I genuinely didn't do much, but I knew what I had to do to get, like, the courses I wanted and stuff, so for university, so it was all fine, really. I've got no really regrets in terms of school. I mean, fourth year, I thought it mattered a lot more than it did for, like, the exams, but it turns out that it didn't really, so I could have probably fucked about a bit more in fourth year, but
yeah,
I took it seriously and it was decent.
I did good enough for what I needed, yeah.
I'm fucking worried about that.
I just said I've worked as hard as I needed to ensure that I was able to choose what I wanted to when I was older.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Just put enough time into it, I guess, but yeah.
Could you imagine, like, what... how we would have lived 6 years if we knew that we didn't have exams?
I know. Yeah. That would probably never go to business on Friday.
No, we would never go to business on Friday.
Like, we'd get to a Friday lunch and be like, we'd always end up going, but we'd always be like,
I wish I hadn't spent time on a fucking dissertation that they didn't even bother to read.
One thing I can say is that dropping higher English was the best decision. Of my life. Oh, I didn't, not even dropping it, I didn't even take it.
We didn't even take it.
It was a decision we took together.
Miss Duncan was like, you could do higher English, but you wouldn't get me. And I was like, if I ain't getting Miss Duncan, it ain't happening. Like,
it's not worth it.
It isn't, and you don't need it. When they say you need you don't need higher
English. I was low-key kind of scared because I thought everyone would want higher English, but
you don't need higher English.
You don't need higher English.
And I love that I didn't take higher English.
I love it so much.
Do you feel like over the past 6 years, you've had any regrets regarding relationships?
Yes. All right. Nah, it's all right. Fucking 100%, yes. But let's not go into that.
I mean, let's, James, we'll just go there. I mean, I think all of my relationships have been pretty disastrous.
I would say I regret. But apart from that, no.
Cammy!
No, I don't regret Cammy at all.
Will I get the photo out?
No.
I regret going to Westburn.
None of us regret going to Westford.
Me too.
Look at him doing his camera. What's up, bud?
Speak up, bro. You do.
What?
I don't know what you want to...
Fucking shell game.
Oh my...
shell game. It's one of the two, like...
I had a long relationship that ended not so good. No. It ended pretty bad.
Fair enough, I won't ask about it.
But, you know, I regret lots of things.
Like what?
Morgan. Meg.
I'm so disappointed you brought up Morgan and Meg and not Ailey.
Camera's still rolling. Camera's still rolling.
Neil is a male version of a nun. A monk? Marcus has had just so many failed relationships. Remember when you turned those two people by? Oh my god.
Oh, that was an S1!
That counts!
Yeah, it counts!
That does not count!
You ruined them! You ruined them! You've taken away their sole purpose in life to reproduce, Marcus. What have you done? You're a criminal. That's what you are. You belong in jail for that.
Shut up.
Deny it?
Ailey, okay.
Oh my god. What was that, Neil? That was just upsetting. You just did such a bad job.
God,
you spit no game. You have no game. Wait!
Wow. She was like, look at that ginger kid.
Yeah, she's like, oh my god, he's so sexy.
He's cute.
Look how bulky he is.
Look at, he's packing. He's packing. He's schmeeting. He's got the muscles going. He's addicted to the gym.
So
what more do you want?
Well.
I regret putting up with some stuff.
Ooh.
But I don't regret the entire thing, if that makes sense.
That's fair.
I get you.
You get me?
I don't regret stuff because I've learned from that I don't like that type of guy. So I look for what's best.
Who the hell are you talking about?
Oh.
Oh god. Cammy was trying to go up Anna, but Anna wouldn't go with that and you wouldn't go without me. So Guy was like, you said, can you do a homie a favour? The worst part is him and Anna, like across, like we were in the little booth in the pizza hut, and him and Anna like going to each other like, oh no, they're going to me. He's like, ask her out, she's there. That's like where she is when they're doing that.
I'm not her.
No. Yeah, like, yeah, you got to pretend you're
her. Oh, sorry.
I wouldn't say regrets. I'd say there's been incidents within relationships that I regret. But apart from that...
No, I wouldn't say regrets particularly, because that would be harsh on it.
Remember when wrote me a poem?
Yeah, that was cute. That came into my head. I can't believe I've gotten declined. She says she's leaving, but that ain't gonna stop me from achieving. That's so hell. I remember it all. It was written on Rhymer's Block.
I don't know what the people want to hear.
Don't worry, I'm sure the people can wait until I'm pissing.
Well, you know, I'd say the founder, Callum Robinson,
yeah,
and potentially myself,
yeah,
we, and who else was it?
Ewan.
That was it. And
Arthur. Yeah. Oh,
what?
Never mind. That's why the group was founded. There was too many members to become just like a. So we had like a
cult.
Yeah, we were gonna get T-shirts made, but it never came about. We never got funding.
Oh, yeah. One, fair enough. Two. I think she's a fucking piss stick. But you know what? It's fine.
What was the third one?
It's dark times, man. Dark times.
Okay, we won't go there. Every time I look at you, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to, maybe we'd be so fine. Oh, life could be a dream. Shaboom, if I could take you up in paradise up above. Shaboom, then tell me, darling, I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and hope we meet again. Boom, boom, boom. Hey, ling, 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 ling. Shaboom, if I could take you up in paradise up above. Shaboom, and tell me, darling, I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and hope we meet again. Boom, boom, boom. Ding-dong, ding-dong. Sha-ling-a-la-ling-a-la-ling-a-la-ling-a-la-oh. Oh, oh, bip. Sha-bip-a-ro-ba-dip. Oh, life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do-do-do-do-shaboom.